consistency. One night you won't go against the wall. It's a surface jump. You're on a unicycle and you're in the audience from the long road on the long lines. Now, I had seen strange films in the late 1960s and early 1970s, things like Led Zeppelin, Woody Herman's orchestra. That sort of thing is considered dead. Putting some poor soul on stage in a unicycle before a kiss was tough enough for a regular one to get the kiss. In the summer of 1975, we still opened some shows to him. We played as a support act for Black Sabbath and Green Day. But in those cases, the venues were massive. The first show we played with Sabbath was at the Baltimore Civic Center for 10,000 people. And again, just as a year before, whether or not we opened, we did a full-on Kiss show. We had pyro and big Kiss logos on the lineups. That night in Baltimore, nobody took down or thought their song. So Sabbath played in front of a huge Kiss logo. The next night, we were scheduled to open for Sabbath again, this time in Providence, Rhode Island. Their people told us no pyro to do. Fine, we said. Fine, let's do it down. We're not playing. We know where to reach us if you change your mind. It was our way out of nowhere. We felt committed to doing a Kiss show. We really were prepared not to do the show. A little while later, the phone rang at the hotel. Okay, come back to the venue. You show the way you want to. By this point, Philip Point had hatched a plan. Sometimes 20 feet long, held taut on mic stands and phone, so you would Thank you. hard for me to have to work. Everything has to be handled for show them we are exactly what they think we are. It took me time and some trial and error, but soon enough I knew what to do. In fact, I knew I was pretty damn good. The difference between a guy who's just gotten his commercial pilot license and a seasoned pilot is that the first one was in a flying jet, while the other one was having to deal with many all situations. Quite a lot, you know, flight time. This is your captain circuit. Stage, I really did get off on something else at all. The crowds at our shows were ecstatic, and we were all sharing the interpretation. Troy and I actually enjoy our fans as leaders, and they kept my insecurities and my happiness at bay. All the problems in the world, theirs and ours, will still be there tomorrow, and we were going to have a great time tonight. We also got to take a few heroes on the tour with us. That fall of 1975, Slay and the Wizard and fronted by Roy Wood and the new open shows for us. Roy Wood's band created an eccentric version of Phil Spector's Wall of Sound. His bass player wore roller skates and they were booed off stage. Afterwards, I told Roy what a huge influence he had been on. He was still shell shocked from getting booed and was disappointed enough to get much of a reaction. After the first show we played with Slay, we all stayed in a chatted room in Churchill, a hotel. I'd ever seen them, but I used to knock over a dollar of cardboard to